In this edition of Inside Blue Host Football, Presbyterian College takes on the SoCon for the second week in a row. In field conditions and weather conditions, let us just say they weren't very good. But we have a lot of highlights to share with you, have a visit with the coach, and a lot more in this edition of Inside Blue Host Football.
Inside Blue Host Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Host Football, along with the coach Harold Nichols. I'm Eric Thacker, and coach, yes, the weather conditions was a big story, but I took a couple of things out of this contest. I thought it was a good football game despite the weather conditions. Two teams that fought hard. Mm-hmm. Your offensive line came back for the first time this year, kind of intact there, and we saw some other people step up. So despite us not getting the decision, I liked how your Blue Hosts fought. They played hard, and some other people stepped up and played well.
Yeah, you know, like you mentioned, the conditions were less than ideal, no doubt about it. But, you know, both teams had to play in it. I think that, I told the team before the game that it was going to be a line of scrimmage game. Anytime you play in conditions like that, I really felt like that was going to be the case, and it certainly was. I think, at the end of the day for us, we had the lead going into the fourth quarter. You know, we've been in a couple of games like this where, you know, the game kind of hung in the balance there late. And where the difference between this year and last year we found a way to win those type games, made plays in the fourth quarter. This year, for whatever reason, if I could put my finger on it, I would. But, we've been unable to make those plays. And, you know, a lot of credit goes to Western Carolina. They're a talented team. That Mitchell kid, their quarterback, was a dynamic player and really played well. And they had some really good receivers. But, at the end of the day, we got to make those plays in the fourth quarter in close games in order to come away with a win.
As we mentioned, we have a lot of highlights. The special teams as well played outstanding. Stephen Dorr, again, stepping up as our punter, an outstanding afternoon. But we'll begin with the defense. Let's dive in.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we have the defensive highlights. Here's Western on offense. We've got a little twin set here to the field and one back. That back, Newsom, was a really good player. And this is a fourth and short, and there's, Deron Dickey, might have been Darius that jumped in there and got a play right off the edge. That's Donnell Williams. Donnell Williams had another big game. Nice play right there on a fourth and short right there. That was their first drive of the game. Here they come out in another open formation and doubles. A lot of their stuff was out of the gun. Come back and fake a little fake to the back. Spit it out there to the receiver, and there's Ed Britt on a nice tackle out here to the field. You can kind of see the end zone shot of it. They were field turf, so it kind of held up pretty good. And there's Ed Britt with his feet up underneath him making a good tackle. Here they are. They got trips to the field. They've kind of flexed their tight end out here. I think we've got a first down call here. It's Donnell getting back in the box. I do a little lead option. There's Deron Dickey. Nice job on the lead blocker. Being nice, hat and hands and feet, creating a little bubble, setting a point. And then you're going to see big Derek Washington coming in here and cleaning it up right there. Bam! That's a big hit right there by my man Derek. Here's a first down call. They're hurrying up. Run a little motion with a little fly sweep right there and a hand the ball off to the back. And a lot of folks right there. That might have been Curry Rozier kind of sifting that thing out here at the five technique down here to your right. You can see a good shot of it here. And he's squeezing down the play, gets in there and makes a big tackle. There's Deron Dickey and Ed and J.C. Didell, a bunch of them in there on the tackle. Another open formation. You got tight end down here to the bottom. Got back weak. Got a little pass right there. Big sack right there by my man Obina Tesawe. And The big U.
Yep.
Ugana Akko on the scoop and score right there. It's a big play in the ball game. I've got a feeling this might be a candidate for collision of the week. But there's my man Obina right there at three technique. And I tell you what, he really has really come on. He's gotten healthy. He's playing pretty well. They tried to cut him right there, and there he is right there. Big hit on the quarterback, Ugana, who can really run.
No the monster way that, can fly.
There's no way that those offensive linemen were going to catch him right there. That's a big play for the Blue Hose, and that's a defensive highlight.
Well, we said it many times, Coach, that defensive line is superb. Both the platoons that come in and play for you, and that was a big-time scoop and score after a real big hit. I thought the defense most of the game, especially shutting down the running game in the first half, was definitely there.
Yeah, you know, I think we let one spit out in the second half, you know, that long touchdown run, which is disappointing. You know, we've got to stay away from those two or three big plays, you know.
Right. That,
you know, because for the most part, I thought our defense played really well.
They did.
You know, you mentioned the defensive line. We play a lot of guys up front and try to keep them fresh in there and feel really good about those units. But, you know, we just got to stay away from the big play, you know. Down in and down out, they got good gap integrity. They did a good job getting pressure on the quarterback and making tackles and getting themselves off the field on third down. But, you know, we got to stay away from the big play.
Donnell Williams, 13 tackles on the afternoon. One of the better tacklers in the conference, now in the top five in terms of total tackles as a conference defender. Let's go ahead and take our timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the offensive highlights, of course, the special teams, and our collision of the week. And we'll also check the health of the team, the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, when we return here on Inside Blue Hose Football.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Going big game, buddy?
You know it.
Woo, yeah!
Let's see, Gabby, we've got a big game to go to. There she is. So how many goals are you going to score today?
10,000.
10,000?
I like it.
Grab a Bojangles Big Bow Box and feed the whole group with chicken, biscuits, fixins, and tea. Bojangles, it's bow time.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too.
Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
We welcome you back to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football. We're going to dive into the offensive highlights, a couple of new faces for the Blue Hose that made an impact in last Saturday's game.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we have offensive highlights from the Western Carolina game. There's Tam Garrick at quarterback. We got a little fake reverse with Daryl Bridges. Daryl Bridges had another 100-yard game and played really well. Has done a nice job all year for us. And kind of get the linebackers and the safeties going the other way and do a nice job with the fake reverse. Big 12, 14-yard gain. I think this is the touchdown run. Get a little power play right there to the left, and there's Daryl Bridges kind of squirting his way through, running behind his pads, do a decent job at the point of attack, trying to create some movement, and there's Daryl Bridges on the touchdown. Here we are. You can really see the rain coming down here, and really we had one of our better drives when the weather got kind of bad, but we handed off to Quaylen Patterson, true freshman out of Jacksonville, Florida, with a big run right there. And it's good to see him kind of get in there and get his first carries of the year and did a nice job. Here it is, we faked the sweep right there, got a little zone play, and we open up a big crease, and there's Quaylen Patterson right there with the nice run. Here we have a trip set, kind of a stack formation down here to the field, and I think this is the big corner play right here to Joe Perter. You can see the rain. Tam sits in there and makes a nice throw right there to the tight end, and Joe does a nice job adjusting to the ball. Big catch, 49-yard play, longest play of the year for us offensively. So nice job, got some protection here. You see an end zone shot of it right here. You can see Joe right there at the left part of your screen. Runs a nice corner route, gets over the top of the defender, and nice catch, nice concentration by Joe, and carries him for another 10 yards. Big play by Joe Perter. I think this might be the touchdown throw here. It's Deshaun Davis. This is his first career touchdown catch. Makes a nice play on the defensive back, creates some separation. Tam Garrick with a nice throw in the corner of the end zone. I thought we were going to lose Deshaun out the back of the end zone. Yeah, right, and slipped down and fell on the concrete. But good protection right there. Nice ball. There's Deshaun Davis. Good concentration. You can see him slipping in right into almost to the ambulance right there. But that was the offensive highlights. Here's the special teams highlights. It's Tim Hartshorn again kicking off for us. And, I really thought special teams with the, unusual conditions with the weather, I thought they did a good job, were error-free, and did a nice job executing in those conditions. Here's Tim kicking off here. I thought our coverage units were going to be big in the game because they got so much speed in the back end. And Tim does a nice job kicking this ball into the end zone. And they don't get a return ball here, which is big. It was not ideal conditions, to say the least. But I thought our kids really did a good job of executing it under those conditions. And Tim here with the kick has done a pretty decent job all year on the kickoff. Hopefully we can get him kicking off some more. We can score some more points and get our coverage unit out there. But that's a big-time kick under those conditions right there, putting up on the end zone for a touchback. This is one of the extra points for them, I believe, and did a nice job here of getting lined up. They did a little funky formation, and We had to make sure we got set up, got good push in the middle right there, and you can tell the benefit of this kind of team by the kind of push they get, you know. And so I was real proud of all of our special teams.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Well, Coach, nice to see new faces for the Blue Hosts. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, you know, talked about Quaylen Patterson, the freshman running back. Did a nice job coming in there, giving Darryl a break. Deshaun Davis, first touchdown catch of his career. You know, exciting player from Chapman High School right here in the upstate. So, you know, we've got a lot of young guys who are trying to filter in. You know, Rocky Sin and some of those guys on defense are doing a good job. So, you know, it's good. You know, it shows good for the future.
All righty, Coach. You teased it. What probably is going to be our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week, no doubt. Let's take another look. The Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week.
Here we have the Collision of the Week. Being at the sideway on the big sack of the quarterback, bam, right there, and Ugana Akko with the scoop and score. The Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week here. You'll see a good end zone shot of it here with Obina doing a good job of playing off of the cut block. He's got a direct path to the quarterback. This is a big play in the game, too. And really, like I say, really proud of Obina. And you can see him right there really hitting him hard and drawing the ball loose. Ugana right there with the big scoop and score. It looks back to his high school days as a running back. But that's a Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week.
Once again, we thank Nichols Automotive, your one-stop shop for all of your automotive needs, including Yokohama Tires. Now let's take a look at the health of the team. Coach Nichols, our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report.
Please. Well, the good thing to report is I don't have anything to report.
Nice?
You know, this is really the first week we've been relatively healthy. Hopefully get a couple guys back. So, you know, thanks to Dr. Milner and all those folks at Palmetto Bone and Joint for all they do for us.
Alrighty, we'd like to see Snoop Byers back in the lineup, hopefully against Coastal next Saturday. Let's go ahead and take our last timeout. When we come back, we'll have a visit with the coach, Coach's Corner, and our Chick-fil-A look ahead, Coastal Carolina, when we return here to Inside Blue Hose Football.
Ice cream, frosted lemonade, starting at 240 calories.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
There once was a family, a lot like this one. and they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles.
The family needed breakfast, but they got a late start.
They pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed.
We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey.
At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a Cajun filet biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Bojangles, it's bow time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Now our special segment, Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I've got Stephen Doerr here, one of our senior punters from Landrum High School in Landrum, South Carolina. And we're going to talk about the techniques of catching a football and the proper way to catch the ball and get it secured and tuck it away. The first thing is you got to have good eyes and hands contact right here, okay? And you want to form a diamond with your thumb and your index fingers, okay? As the football comes in, you want to make sure you catch the football out and away from your body, okay? And you want to give with the football just a little bit, okay? I want to get the ball out of the air and get it in a tuck position as quick as I possibly can. The longer the ball's in the air or the longer the ball is away from your body, the easier it is for a defender to knock the ball out of your hands. So once you make that good diamond right there and have good hands and eyes, catch, tuck, and secure. Very important pieces right here. Now, those are for all balls that are waist or above. You get a ball that's waist or below, you've got to go pinkies, okay? Now, depending on where the football goes, if it goes lower than your knees, you've got to have good bend in your knees and be able to go down and reach the football. Still importance of hands and eyes together. Once you secure the ball, catch it out away from your body, get the ball secured, tucked, as quick as you possibly can so the defenders can't knock the ball down. Another big part of it too, on a ball that's high, all right, you want to make sure you reach up and catch the ball at its highest point. You don't want to let the ball and catch the ball in your body. You want to make sure you go up and catch the ball at its highest point, get the ball out of the air again to prevent the defenders from knocking the ball out of your hands or out of the air. So it's very important. 4 points. Hands and eyes, make the good diamond. Catch, secure, tuck, okay? Know the differences with the balls that are below your waist and the balls that are above your head. Those are the proper ways to catch a football. That's this week's edition of Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Thank you, Coach. Now, Coastal Carolina. Big game. They're ranked number one in one poll, ranked number two in another poll. We played them tough last year. Break it down, Coach.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Well, I think it's an unbelievable opportunity. You know, Coastal has got a great program down there. You know, they made the announcement this past summer that they're making the jump to FBS. And they've, you know, contributed a lot of resources, not only to football, but to a lot of their programs. And, you know, they're having a great year. You know, they've had some good wins. You know, they beat Western Illinois, beat South Carolina State. They're undefeated. They're ranked number one in the country. They went to the semifinals last year and lost to North Dakota State, which was the eventual national champion. So, unbelievable opportunity for our football team. Huge challenge, no doubt about it, on the road at their place. They've got Ross, the quarterback, who's the preseason all-conference offensive player of the year. You know, they're very, very stingy on defense, got a lot of respect for how they go about their business and they run their program. But, you know, we had our chances last year. You know, we kind of hung in there, gave up a couple of plays late, which hurt us. But, you know, really like our football team. Like I say, we're a resilient bunch. We'll go down there, we'll strap it on, and hopefully have a good game down there against the Coastal Carolina Chanticleers.
Coach, we had the lead in the fourth quarter last year. Mm-hmm. Coach, always a pleasure. Thank you very much for joining us once again. Fans, it's going to be a good one, a good opportunity for the Blue Hose as they face the Chanticleers. Join us next week here on Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors: The Bud Group, Good Times Entertainment, Carolina Concrete, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Midway Barbecue, Hannah Heating and Air Conditioning, Epting Turf and Tractor, Arthur State Bank, Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton, Wilson's Cafe, Tony's Pizza, and Steamer's Cafe.